Hi team! Today we are talking about the Alaris pump. So if you've never worked with one or you are new to the Alaris pump, stay tuned. We're going to talk about how to get it started, some of the programs, and a little bit of troubleshooting right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy and this is NurseMinder and we do everything nursing here. So if you're new, consider subscribing and you'll be notified when the next video is released. So let's get on to the Alaris pump, and there's no better way to work with it than to actually have one in front of us. So we're going to go right to the lab. So let's get started and turn this baby on. Now the Alaris pump will do some system checks before we can program anything in here for our patient. And for demonstration purposes, I've chosen to have two channels already attached to the pump. The first screen we're going to see is, do you have a new patient? Selecting no means you've worked with this patient for a while and the previous settings will be displayed. Selecting yes will take us to the next screen and ask us if we are in adult critical care. Selecting yes will take us to a specific menu for critical care patients. We're going to select no, which will take us to the menu for the med-surg units. Here we have another option to go adult critical care, adult general, education for adults, etc. We are selecting adult general. Confirm at the bottom, so let's go ahead and press that confirm. Patient ID entry, you can simply hit confirm at this stage, or you can enter in the patient's ID and then hit confirm. Now it's taking us to our channels A and B. You can't press these little arrows, instead you need to select on the channel itself which pump you're working with. So let's go ahead and select channel A. After selecting our channel, we are now prompted to select the type of fluids we are infusing. Let's go into guardrail drugs. Here we have a menu of medications that you might be administering to your patient. You'll notice the right hand side has a menu that we also can select. This has groupings of medications, for example, A to E, F to J. If we select one of those, it will break it down to A, B, C, D, E, which quickly allows us to find the drug that we're looking for example, cefazolin, and select it. You can see we already have pre-programmed doses in the machine. So you simply need to select the one that you've mixed up. 1 gram and 50 mils as an example. The machine will ask if this is correct. We'll select yes. It will then take us through a screen which shows us the breakdown of drug dilutant and concentration. And then the next screen is going to tell me how fast this drug has already been programmed to run. It's important to note that a nurse's responsibility is to make sure that the information on this pump is in accordance with your agency policy before you press start. Once started, the machine will start to deliver the medication you have put in. Now you'll note that my channel A says to check IV set, and that is because I actually have not put in my line yet. Let's rewind. Let's go back to when we first selected our channel and go under guardrail IV fluids this time. Here you'll find where your blood products and your electrolytes are housed. You'll also find a general IV solution button here, and this is what we use when we do a basic infusion for normal saline, for example, or Ringer's lactate. So we're going to go back now and select that IV solution under I. And is this correct? Yes, it is. And now you can see where you can set in the rate and the volume to be infused. I've got a 250 ml bag. I always like to leave myself room, so I'm just going to put 200 mils. So when it beeps at me, I've got about a half an hour left. And then I simply just press start and my infusion will go. So let's insert our line. We're going to open up the clamp, take off our blue cathlon off our primary line, and seat the pump portion of the IV line into the appropriate chambers. We're going to close the safety clamp and make sure our roller clamps and everything are open so that the fluid can flow, and then we can hit start once it's attached to our patient. Now we just need to verify that what we programmed is in fact going in through our channel. You'll notice on the screen across on channel A it says IV solution, and that is exactly what I programmed, and that the rate is 100 mils per hour, and the green light indicates my line is in fact infusing. Now if we look at some troubleshooting, what happens when that green light changes? For example, what if I get some air in the line? You'll notice that the light has changed from green to red and it's flashing air in the line. That means the tubing within the chamber is problematic. The first step is to select the channel and to hit start. That is your first troubleshooting. If that clears it, awesome! If it doesn't, you're going to get another alarm, air in the line. So step two is to take the safety clamp off and examine the line inside the chamber. I can see that there are a few air bubbles in here, and so what I'm going to do is just gently stretch this line out and flick those air bubbles upwards to get rid of them so that when I seat it back in the pump, it's going to work. Now, it's always a good idea to wait a few seconds to make sure that, in fact, the pump is working properly. The next troubleshooting we're going to look at is when there's a problem downstream of the chamber. So we now see it's checking the line, and that's because I've occluded the clamp, the roller clamp, so I can demonstrate this for you. So it's gone to yellow while the machine is checking the line to see where is the source of this problem. It will soon tell me that it is occluded on the patient's side. This is an indicator I need to look at the line from the machine to the patient. And what I'm going to find is my clamp, I forgot to unroll it. Happens all the time. I'm going to unroll that, select my channel, and start my infusion. Wait a few seconds, make sure everything is fine before you turn your back, because if you don't, three steps away, it's going to be beeping at you. Now, there is the option to pause the machine for a few moments if you're working with the patient. Select the channel, hit pause. You see the yellow light come on. Or if you want to turn the channel off completely, maybe you're disconnecting for a shower, again, select the channel. You're going to hold down the channel off button for a count of three. It's located under the pause button. One, two, three, and you can release, and then you're going to see that the channel is powering down. Well, that's our lesson for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Give a thumbs up if it was helpful. Comment below and let me know what you think. And if you have some ideas for future videos, put them there as well. Be sure to subscribe. You'll be the first to know when the next video comes out. I've got some other videos populating here that you might be interested in, so enjoy, and until next time, make it a great day.